Welcome back to Chem Reactor. In today's video, we are going to discuss a very important synthetic reagent in organic synthesis, NN carbonyl dimidazole, or in short, we call it as a CDI. It's byproducts and side products. Whether you're a medicine chemist or a process chemist, it is very important to know what are the byproducts and side products can form in your reaction. Because it is very important to know these side products and byproducts for better reaction yields. CDI is a white crystalline solid. It is much safer, more efficient and user-friendly alternative to toxic fosgen. I use both CDI as well as fosgen in my PhD and postdocs. I remember back in the 2019 when I was doing a postdoc in medicinal chemistry, I had to do a structure activity relationship study. So I used to make a lot of acetoic anhydrides by using fosgen. So I remember that time I had to always wear detectors, as well as my postdoctoral boss, he used to stand just behind me to watch out on me, is that everything going on well. In the synthetic applications of CDI, I already uploaded the video on this topic. So here we can make amide, ester, as well as carbamide and anhydrides from by activating carboxylic acids. Along with this, we can also do a cyclization reactions as well as substitution reactions by using the CDI. For more details on synthetic applications of CDI, you can watch out this video on YouTube. To better understand CDI byproducts, first we will look into the reaction mechanism. For that, I have taken here amide formation as an example. If you look at this reaction mechanism, CDI deprotonates carboxylic acid into a carboxylate anion. This carboxylate anion then adds to this protonated CDI that forms this mixed anhydride. In the next step, this released imidazole reacts with this mixed anhydride and then forms this acyl imidazole as an intermediate. At the same time, this releases this imidazole as well as carbon dioxide as a byproducts. And then finally, amine adds to this acyl imidazole intermediate that forms this amide, as well as releases this another imidazole molecule. By looking at the reaction mechanism, CDI forms two common byproducts, carbon dioxide and imidazole. So here, carbon dioxide, this is a gas released during the reaction of CDI with nucleophiles like carboxylic acid and amines. And the second byproduct, imidazole, it is a benign byproduct that often act as a base during the reaction by eliminating the need of external base in many reactions. As you know, imidazole is a very water soluble, so it can be easily removed in aqueous reaction workup. So in total, CDI forms two byproducts, carbon dioxide and imidazole. Carbon dioxide is a gas, so it is already released during the reaction, and the imidazole form can be removed by using the aqueous reaction workup. Now let's break down into the CDI side products. What are the common side products formed in CDI coupling reactions? The first step is a decomposition of CDI. CDI can decompose over the time, especially when it comes into contact with the moisture, that leads to the formation of imidazole as well as the carbon dioxide. We can avoid this decomposition of CDI under the moisture by storing under inert atmosphere and low temperature. Also, if you're planning to run a next CDI coupling reaction, try to use freshly open or prepared CDI. The second side product of this CDI can be intramolecular cyclization. This can happen in a peptide synthesis, particularly when dipeptides leading to the cyclic compounds. Here, for example, the amide coupling of this acid with the amine that goes through this intermediate. So, but in the next step, this intermediate reacts with this amine to form this expected amide as a product. But instead of forming this amide, it can form this diketopiperazine as a side product. So this is another major side product that can be formed during this CDI coupling reactions. We can avoid this by running the reaction at low temperature or use of protecting groups on the other reactive functional groups. Next up in the list is racemization. If the carboxylic acid or amine has a chiral center, the minimal racemization can happen, especially under the basic conditions. So here, if you are taking example of this R substituted propionic acid and aniline reaction under the CDI conditions, that can form expected products, substituted R propanamide, but along with that, it can racemize this R configuration to ES, substituted propanamide. We can avoid this by use of hydroxybenzotriazole or hydroxyazobenzotriazole as an additive and running this reaction at a low temperature. Another side product of CDI is anhydride formation. The mixed anhydride intermediate can react with the additional carboxylic acid that forms this acid anhydride as a product instead of amide bond. To avoid anhydride formation, we should avoid use of excess carboxylic acid, and also the another reason forming this anhydride formation is insufficient reactivity of amine. Finally, urea formation. Excess use of CDI can lead to the formation of symmetrical urea as a side product or the impurity. This symmetrical urea formation can be avoided by using the stoichiometric amounts of CDI or slightly excess in the reaction. Key takeaways: CDI can form two common byproducts, imidazole and carbon dioxide, and in side products it can decompose under moisture conditions that can form intermolecular cyclizations, racemization, as well as urea and anhydride formation. These are the commonly formed side products in CDI coupling reactions. There can be more than these side product formations depending on what are the studying materials used in the reaction. So finally, CDI byproducts like CO2 and imidazole, these are manageable because CO2 is a gas that gets evolved in the reaction, and imidazole can be washed out easily in the aqueous reaction workup. The side products are arised from improper storage of CDI or excess use of reagents or poor reaction controls. We can avoid these things or the side products by using the proper reagents, equivalents, as well as the storage of the CDI. I hope you enjoyed the video, and please don't forget to like the video and subscribe the channel for more details. See you in the next video.